Welcome to the Pixelberry Choices Podcast. I'm your host, Nirbhan Day, and today we're going to be talking about Chapter 2 of The Nanny Affair, Book 2. And it was an interesting chapter. The events went down there, and we pick it up from where we left at the first chapter. So this is the chapter where we go for the shareholder meeting, and also the boys go to school. At first, we see we're having an awesome time with the boys, but Mickey and Mason, they are a little not comfortable, a little uncomfortable about going back to school. So we get this diamond scene with Sam. We get to go to the nearby park, I suppose, and just do the mini golf course and other fun stuff, you know, really daring stuff we can do with the boys to lift up their spirit and can give them the pep talk they want. I think Mickey needed it more than Mason, the younger of them. And we tell them they were afraid of going to school and starting a new life, and they just wanted to be with our main character and Sam, just playing golf, having fun. So they're going back to school. They have those jitters, and we calm those down. Then we take turn with both the boys, specifically the one who was really concerned. We give a pep talk to that boy, and he calms down. And the other one, the elder one, Mason, I think, we tell Mason that to take care of his younger brother. And then we have one little kiss with Sam when we bring ice cream to the boys, and it was a wholesome day. Then we go to the next thing, that is dropping the kids to the school, new school, that the building, the picture they showed, it was really awesome. And Carter and our main character and Sam, we all were there. We dropped the kids. We go from there. And if we pick the diamond scene, you will see both the boys are so happy. And even Mickey was feeling a little down. He's now super happy to go school, new start. So, you know, we have all been there. So when you go to the school for the first time, there are little jitters and you get a little uncomfortable. But after that, you get used to it. So we'll see later what happened. And then we go to this Dalton company, and we see when we're in Italy, a lot of changes happened there. It looks completely different, and we go into the room. We see, we were told that it's a shareholder meeting where Sam's father wanted our main character too. But we see there only Sam's father, Sophia's father, and Robin. And we get to know that Sophia is in, she's traveling somewhere for honeymoon and alone. So we can show pity to her, or we can say, oh, she's pathetic. But we'll see Sophia's father's reaction. Sophia's father doesn't get angry on our main character saying, oh, it's because of you she's unhappy, or it's because of you. But instead, she says, oh, she's like her mother, really pathetic. So it is, she just takes all of her anger on her own daughter. And no one really brings up the marriage that way to really haunt her, haunt our main character or Sam. But Robin, we see she's salty almost all the time. We see the red thing around her face, so she's super angry. And she, when learned that Sam's father called us not for a shareholder meeting, so she was storming off the room, but Sam's father stops her and says, stops Robin. I should start saying Robin, because Robin is a gender customizable character. So like the nanny, like Sam. So we see Robin saying, Sam's father saying to Robin that, well, that's the only trick I could have played to bring you two in the same room. And then here it is. I've been telling you that it's the competition. So here's the competition. Here it starts. So 3 months from now, that in December, around Christmas time, they'll be announcing the winner and of the competition that will start from now on. And this competition is going to be between Robin and Sam, because both of them let the father down. So now this Dalton Russo Enterprise, it's a group, so they both paired up, and now Sam is disappointed because Sam never thought, after all the things they did for the company, it would go down. But then his father says, this is the final thing, and we are given a project. So from red to black, we need to bring a company or something. I didn't quite get that. But we need to work on and, bring a facility back to life. So something that's not going well in the company, one sector or something, and we need to bring it from red to black sort of state. So then we were dismissed. And then we still didn't know why we're here. So this could probably end up like this. It would be a power battle between Robin and Sam. And then our main character will be standing by Sam, while Sophia will be coming back from wherever she's gone. and then she'll be standing by Robin. So it'd be a battle between two couples. So on one side we have the evil power couple, Robin and Sophie, and on the other hand our main character and Sam. And then we go to this another diamond scene. We go to the company and we see what can suit Sam. So finally end up that robotics, that's what would be the best fit for Sam. That's going to fit Sam the best. So that's Sam's best fit. But also we meet Bazes, one of the character models wearing the glass from Open Heart. And he's also experimenting on this animal thing and wheelchair, some tissue. The same thing Elijah in Open Heart was working on. And Bazes' brother was working on in the book. So that was something there. And then after finally Sam chooses what they would be doing over the course of this time. In the robotics lab, they'll be working. And then we have a steamy romance hookup scene again with Sam in the same robotics lab where we had a romance steamy scene in the last book. And when Sam's brother or sister, Robin, walked in on us. And then, so basically the scenes people liked from book one, they're bringing it back and the people are going to eat it up. So that's what is happening. And then one intern walks in on us, but nothing, no harm done. And then we go to school to pick up the boys, and we stand there with Jordan, the new nanny, and we see other moms, the rich moms and the rich docs and rich parents talking, and specifically one, can't remember her name, but she was talking rough about our main character, and she sees us and say, oh, look, this is a nanny, and you know, what things happened, you know, I ran off with the driver, you know, the kids, and then Sam broke up the wedding, and then we sort of can choose to answer her calmly or angrily. Then Jordan steps up, and then the boys come out, and they are so happy about the class, and Jordan says she has planned some experiment back in the home, and then, as they say, probably Mason has developed a crush for someone. We come back home, we're with Sam, and we're really intimate, and we're close to each other in the penthouse, and we tell everything about Mickey Mason's new school experience, and then really happy. So at first they were really nervous, but right now they're super happy, they're exploding with fun, and Mason's new crush, we talk about all those things, and finally Sam brings this incident that Jordan has told them about, this parents drama that went down. And finally Sam says that we need to get public, we can't keep this act on forever, so we need to go public, but we will be needing someone who would be telling us about how to go public the right way. So the next chapter, the publicist, we will be needing a publicist, so there would be she, so she would be telling us about the right way to go public, how can we go public the right way, but can we trust her or not, we don't know, but we'll see in the next chapter. So about the nanny drama also, we're gonna see why she's there. There could be two reasons, talked about it, like she's an evil appointed by Sophia and Robin, so she just wants to bring dirt on our main character. She will be there, look, Sam doesn't like you, this is it, Sam is just playing you, they wouldn't want you to bring to the public anyway, you're just a fling to them. And then it could be that, and second one should be the genuine one, and she will just at the end, not she or he, whatever, the Jordan, so they will just get their heart broken, they will be confessing to our main character, but our main character is always Sam, so it has always been Sam, and this is one love interest book, and won't be given the option to choose any other love interest other than Sam, so at the end, Jordan will just get their heart broken, if they're genuine, and it will be something like, All the Boys, To All the Boys I've Loved Before. The movie is the John Ambrose. It would be something like that. Because Sam came first and it's always been Sam. So even though Jordan may have feeling for our main character, we'll just have to refuse them saying Sam came first. So two things. But I think Jordan is going to be a diabolical character by the end of this book. We'll see about that next chapter of the publicist. See you when it releases. Let me know in the comment section how did you like the book. And thank you for watching. See you in the next video. Till then, peace out.